Cost estimating. Cost is one of the most important elements to control during the lifetime of a project, and this starts with providing the right cost estimates. Typically, in a project, the total cost of ownership is considered. And this total cost of ownership includes the initial capital investment, also called capital expenditure, CapEx, and the operational cost, also known as the operational expenditure, OPEX. The operational expenditure consists of, for example, maintenance cost, consumables, cost of sales, and the operational cost. In this lecture, we merely focus on estimating the capital expenditure, so CapEx. But remember that the operational expenditure plays an important role in the overall business case of the project. More and more, life cycle cost of the project is taken into account when making decisions. For example, it's not only about the cost for designing and constructing the building, so the CapEx, but it's also about the cost for painting and cleaning of the windows later on, operational expenditure. Let's go back to the capital investment now. Cost estimates evolve during the early project phases. The level of detail grows along the route. There are different types of cost estimates. In the study estimate, for example, a feasibility study, you're looking at the areas of work as the lowest detail. And accuracy varies between 30 and 50%. For an advanced funding estimate, for example, system design, you will look at work package level. And the accuracy is roughly between 20 and 35%. This accuracy range narrows down till about 5% in the tender phase, when you specify your estimate at individual tasks. It's important to realize that an estimate is seldom a single number. It always comes with a margin of uncertainty or accuracy. Take care which estimate you communicate to whom. Not seldom, the first cost estimate is remembered by the project owner, regardless of the bandwidth you indicated. The backbone for your estimate is the work breakdown structure, since that gives a clear overview of the work packages, the tasks and activities that are part of the project. An estimate can be driven by certain budget decisions, so more top-down oriented, or by input from the entire project team and other stakeholders involved, so that's more bottom-up. Applying both methods helps in creating a realistic and feasible estimate. The input of the team members who actually will do the work is crucial. They know best what's required to realize the project deliverables. What are the ingredients of a capital cost estimate? Cost elements can be split into direct and indirect costs. Direct costs are costs that can be directly allocated to a specific scope of work or an activity. For example, equipment, project management, subcontractors, etc. Indirect costs cannot directly be allocated to a specific task. For example, company overhead cost, training of personnel or insurance. And on top of these direct and indirect costs, allowance can be added to the base estimate to cover uncertainties in the scope of work, the so-called known unknowns. And on top of this base estimate, contingency is added to cover the uncertainty and variability associated with the cost estimate and the unforeseeable elements in the project scope definition. Typically, the base estimate will increase, and both allowance and contingency will decrease when further detailing and developing the project. The final ingredient of the capital cost is called escalation. This is related to the time value of money and market factors in general. In this example, it's shown how the market factor, here referred to as a location factor, and the money of the day will influence the cost estimate. What estimating methodologies are commonly used in projects? To select the appropriate strategy, you need to determine the required level of accuracy of the estimate, also taking into account what level of project definition is available. Let's have a look at four methods, ordered from a rough estimate towards a more detailed estimate. The subjective method, also called guesstimating, is applied to provide a ballpark figure at the early stage of the project. The accuracy of this estimate, and you make it on the back of a coaster or a small piece of paper, strongly depends on the estimator's experience. The comparative method uses similar past projects to estimate the cost of a new project. It's applied when there's not sufficient data available to generate a detailed estimate yet, but sufficient technical information to see analogies with earlier projects. Scaling factors can be applied to account for the differences in the project. Parametric estimating, also called component ratio method, is a technique that develops cost estimates based upon relationships between a project's characteristics and the resources consumed during its development, manufacture, and maintenance. For parameters, think of functional design parameters, quantities of equipment, or onshore versus offshore, as an example of the operational environment. The analytical method, also called detailed or engineering build-up, is typically used for a control estimate or bid estimate. Hence, the project is already detailed to a large extent. Based on the work breakdown structure, for every nut and bolt, the cost can be estimated. And then the sum of all pieces, including overhead, becomes the project estimate. Close cooperation between the cost estimator and the engineers is required in this method. So let's summarize what we've seen so far. Here we illustrate the development of the cost estimate accuracy and the estimating methods as the project matures from front-end to execution. The base estimate grows and the range of the estimates decreases. In the early project phases, subjective and analogous methodologies are typically applied, while parametric and analytical methodologies are used when there's a more detailed project definition. In estimating, the human aspect plays a role in different ways. The estimator should involve team members using a proactive and open approach. Different stakeholders have different interests in the project, and they might try to influence the cost estimate. A business manager, for example, is more interested in submitting a competitive bid, aiming at winning the tender, so she will push for a lower estimate. A project manager wants to deliver the project within the budget, so she will push for at least a realistic estimate, and maybe even some extra buffer. And next to these interests, we tend to be too optimistic in any case. Optimistic in our cost estimate, optimistic in the benefits, resulting in a viable business case. However, realization might be disappointing with higher costs and lower benefits. To conclude, an estimate is an estimate. It's not a fixed number up front. It grows along with the project while uncertainties decrease and its accuracy also increase. It's not only hard science though. The human aspect plays a role as well.